Good day, everyone. The lecture is about to start. You're all welcome to this platform. We have all been aware, as we have been aware, is an ICT platform where we teach schools, teach students, both the ones that have an ICT teacher in their school and the ones that don't. It's a platform that we used to teach them, to enlighten them about their computer, about ICT, and everything concerning ICT. We pray we are going to make the most use of this platform, and we pray we'll be able to deliver what we need to deliver unto you, that we can have a better ICT student. In the name of the Almighty God. My name is Tafashiide Abawale Joshua, an ICT teacher in Luasa Senior High School, and I'll be the one taking you through the lectures. I know you are going to get the best out of this. I pray God helping me to be able to deliver the best for you. Like we said, we are starting today. We are starting today, and the topic we are starting with, is an overview of computer system. I pray that as you go with all, as we go in it, you will, and God will help us to deliver the best out of it. In Jesus' name. Looking at the screen and see the topic there, you can see the topic there, computer studies, overview of computer system, more or less like an introduction into computer system, introduction to ICT, introduction to computer system. Under this, you'll be looking at the definition of a computer, components of hardware, types of hardware, characteristics of a computer, advantages of a computer, and benefits of computer to schools. You agree with me that the school, not only the school, the whole world in general, we are in a computer age, and it has its own way of making things easier and faster for each and every one of us. Here we look at the learning objectives. At the end of this lecture, the student should be able to define a computer, state the components of the computer, define hardware, give the types of hardware with examples, and state the characteristics of computer, and state the benefits of computer. This is what we are expected to know at the end of this lecture. Let's move on. Here you can see the diagram of a computer system. Here, you see the monitor, see the keyboard, the mouse, the CPU, which you also call the system unit, the scanner, the printer, the speaker, the headphone, all these together forms the system. When you connect them together, they form a computer system. So what exactly is a computer? What exactly can we say a computer is? It says it's an electronic device. In the sense that it uses electricity to operate. I also call it an electronic machine that accepts data as input through the input devices, processes the data, produces the result as output through the output devices, and stores the results. It is a programmable device that stores, retrieves, and processes the data, and is also referred to as a mechanical device, as it can replace the human computers. You as a human being are a human computer. Yes, You yourself, you are a form of a computer yourself as a human being. But the computer, which is an electronic device, a mechanical device, can be used to do what you are supposed to do as a human being at a faster rate, more accurately, more precisely, more efficiently. That is why it is called a computer. You have the components of the computer. The components of the computer, you have the hardware, the software, you as an, a human being, because it's always assumed that without a human being, the computer cannot be operated. Without a human being, the computer cannot be operated. The computer cannot operate itself. That's the reason why we have that. So the hardware, what's an hardware? Some people will say that the hardware is that part of the computer that we can see and touch. No. Those are always used at least to just make you understand what the computer is. They're used to make you understand what the computer is. They simply put, the hardware is the part of the computer that helps or aids or assists the computer to perform its functions, to perform its, to be able to use it for what it's supposed to use for. Those parts of the computer, those physical parts of the computer, which helps it to perform its function. Without these devices, the work of the computer will not be seen. Neither will the effect be seen. The hardware is divided into the system unit and the peripheral devices. The peripheral devices, you have the input device, output device, storage device. The system unit, that's where the work of the computer is done. That's when you say it accepts data, it processes data. It is the system unit that actually processes it. And it's also called the CPU. The CPU, which is the central processing unit. The central processing unit. The storage devices, these are devices that helps the computer to store its information. You have the primary storage and you have the secondary storage. The primary storage readily comes with the computer, while the secondary storage, you attach them to your computer system. You attach the secondary storage to your computer system so that it performs its functions. These are examples of input devices. The microphone, which is voice input, the mouse, the keyboard. You have a light pen, digital camera, a joystick, a scanner. These are other examples of, and the card reader is also another example of input devices. The input devices helps you to pass information from you as the user to the computer. You deliver information from you as the user to the computer. While the output devices, they help you to receive information from the computer system. To receive information from the computer system, we have the monitor, the speaker, the printer, the projector is another example. The photocopier is another example of output devices. What are the characteristics of a computer? Characteristics of a computer. Why is it a computer? Because it has a high speed, it is accurate, the computer is diligent. The computer, and if you say diligent, that it performs millions of tasks with the same consistency. Versatility, in the sense that you can perform different tasks at the same time. You can use your computer to do different things at the same time. Reliability, the work of the computer is highly reliable. Memory, in terms of memory, it has high storage capacity. It works automatically. It performs its task automatically. Performs its tasks automatically. And these are the characteristics of the computer. So what are the advantages of a computer? Those are things you can see there. Human productivity is increased. It helps connect to the internet. It can store large amount of information. It can store large amount of information to reduce waste. It helps to sort, organize, and search through information. It helps to get a better understanding of data. helps in learning and keeping informed through researches made from the internet, and serve as a source of income as a teacher, computer operator of different kinds. Under computer studies, you can go into web designing and program designing, software designing, and all other areas in which you can have a computer. And here you have some tasks you can give to yourself. List out 5 benefits of a computer in schools, hospitals, public sector, a company, and an airport. So this, with all this, you can at least have a good introduction of what a computer system is. And we said the components of a computer, we have a hardware, software, and a humanware. Talking about the software, this is a part of the computer which is a part of the computer in which contains instructions, programs which are needed for the computer to operate. Under the software, you have the system software and the application software. The system software, they are the ones that contain information that actually operates the computer. It cannot be manipulated upon. Contains instructions, programs which the computer needs to operate. Without it, the application software cannot function.